We're here with Tony from ESP in, well, what I consider to be kind of like Willy Wonka
chocolate factory.
Disneyland.
Disneyland,
like
yeah.
Disneyland for guitars.
We are in the ESP USA shop and I've had a little sneak peek and it's so exciting in there. But at the door, you're greeted by what I believe to be one of the first ESP USA guitars made. Is that correct?
Yes, exactly. So this is a guitar that was built from the very first run of ESP USAs that we made back in 2013.
Is it that long?
It's been around for, almost 10 years now. So the shop has come a long way since this guitar was built, but yeah, this is one of the original ones.
When you say coming a long way, with it being ESP USA, this is probably still very bloody good.
Oh no, it's an incredible instrument. But yeah. You know, as we've talked about today, you know, our standards are always really just trying to make it a little bit better every year. You know,
we yeah.
try to just, you know, just constantly improving
and innovating
dialing things
and improving.
In.
Yeah,
exactly.
And the Eclipse is a very fine example of that. You're constantly kind of innovating this classic design to push it further.
Exactly.
In the future. And with that as well, if you haven't already, check out our little rundown of the ESP 2022 range with Tony here and some beautiful artist guitars here on PMTVUK. On YouTube, right? That's all the admin done. Let's go check out the shop. This is
sounds
amazing.
Good.
So cool.
So we're starting right now in final assembly. So this is kind of the last place the guitars, you know, get all the hardware, pickups, everything installed before they're put in cases and sent out the door.
Very cool. And you pointed out a beautiful guitar down there. If you wouldn't mind touching
absolutely.
On that. So we were talking about Gary Hull quite a bit off camera and his love for ESP and how he innovates this, the Eclipse design to suit him. And he always has some damn fine looking guitars. His
absolutely.
Guitars are always beautiful, and this is something special and new, isn't it?
This was a finish that we used on Gary's first ESP USA that we made him here. It was a new finish at the time, and we call this Hellfire.
Yeah.
So it is a very unique looking finish, but super cool.
Is this for Gary, or is this just like a test kind of?
This was something we worked on with Gary. It was a collaboration.
Okay.
It was a new finish we came up with. Our painter, Ryan, came up with that at the time. Gary wanted something a little different than what we were doing.
Yeah.
So yeah, Ryan came up with this, and it's something that we've continued doing at the USA shop, and it's just a very unique, beautiful finish.
Yeah, man, again, constantly pushing the envelope with making unique guitars.
Always trying to do something different. Innovation is definitely the right word. So
hell yeah.
Trying to do something different.
So what I've got behind me, the final assembly.
Down.
Because again, it's a very small, intimate operation, this, isn't it?
Absolutely. You know, I think we only have about 12 to 15 employees, something
really?
Like that over here. So it's a lean and mean crew, but all these guys are extremely talented. They're extremely skilled in what they do. And, you know, this type of work, it's very specialized. It's not something that, you know, it takes years of learning and experience to kind of get to the level where these guys are at the USA shop. So we're very proud of that that fact and of just all the incredible work that they're doing over here.
Yeah,
so,
I mean, speaking of incredible work, I've only ever seen pictures of an ESP USA, let alone hold one. Can I pick one of these up?
You absolutely can.
Look at this. That's well-balanced. That's a well-balanced guitar there. That you can feel immediately when you pick up guitar. When you play as many guitars as you do when you work for a music company or for a guitar company, you play a lot of guitars and you always find the good ones. This is a good one.
Oh yeah.
Even without plugging it in.
You just know. I mean, when you can hear a guitar, especially when you feel it acoustically, you can hear that it's going to be a good sounding guitar.
Without
you're playing
a
guitar.
Of
yeah. All the ESP USAs are on that level. We don't put nothing leaves this building without being on that level of playability and quality.
Oh yeah, totally.
That's what we're going for.
Flame's
over here.
Amazing, the natural binding.
Yeah, that top is
beautiful.
You've
got the glorious contours on the back.
Yep, got a nice waist cut, the super smooth set heel joint.
Yeah.
We're using all stainless steel frets over here.
Immediately you can tell as soon as you pick it up.
Oh yeah.
So yeah, I expect nothing less from the USA ESP shop.
It's a beautiful guitar.
So cool.
Here. So check out one of these new. All right, so this is something we call Lynch Burst.
I wonder why.
So obviously this kind of color scheme was inspired by our friend George Lynch.
Sorry, again, just the weight. Just the a lot of time and effort must go into this. You're not picking any random pieces of alder or basswood off the shelf or mahogany.
The balance is key, as you know. If you ever picked up a guitar that has a weird neck dive or anything like that, you know, it really affects your playing in not a good way. So balance is key. Something we definitely take into account when building any of these guitars.
Yeah, it feels very special to play as well, and the attention to detail, even not putting a stupid piece of foam under here, it's all painted in the recessed Floyd cavity and stuff. It's a great thing.
Down to the last detail.
For sure, I'm scared to put this back. Can you put this back?
I got you. I'm going to show you one more. This is a Horizon. Mm-hmm. A beautiful green.
So light. This thing's going to sing.
Oh, yeah. Again, with the beautiful natural maple binding, mm-hmm. smooth contour on the back.
Yeah.
Arch top, string through body.
These are glorious looking guitars, man. And we saw the Gary Holt before, so you do unique stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Very pretty stuff. But you're also quintessentially still ESP, and I can see some splatter gold in the back.
Yeah, we can check those out.
Yeah, I'll let you put this back again.
Here, why don't you go ahead and grab that? I trust you.
Look at that.
This is a bare bones Eclipse before it's gotten all the pickups and parts put on it. But
Eclipse with a Floyd, I love it.
Yep.
The back of the neck as well.
Yeah, let me show you this other one so you can see kind of what we were going to talk about, how our painter Ryan, each one of these is hand-painted. Every one of them is completely unique. You can mm-hmm. see two Eclipses with this gold splatter finish. They're totally different. So that is one really, really cool thing about the USA shop when we're doing special finishes like this, like the gold splatter or the blood splatter. You know, Ryan is doing these by hand. Each one is a completely one of a kind.
Yeah, you're not screen printing a graphic on it.
Exactly. All... See, it goes on the back of the body too.
That's so
cool.
So
it's just, you know, it's pretty next level.
It's a lovely neck as well. It's very nice. Very special.
Very special, absolutely. All right. Well.
Where next? Lead the way, man.
Actually, let's go that way.
Let's go this way.
I'll show you something you'll appreciate.
The restroom. I'll show you something you'll appreciate.
Yeah, no, come follow me.
Straight to the restroom.
Here's a different room. So.
This is cool.
This is our wood room.
Oh, as a guitar nerd, I'm so happy I'm in here right now.
As a guitar nerd, this makes me very happy as well. So this is where we store our wood. Obviously, we really deal in nothing but just like the highest end, you know, type tops. We do a bunch of exotic tops mm-hmm. for limited runs and different things we're doing with USA.
No one quite does an exotic top like ESP.
Yeah, no, we
definitely think that.
We spend a lot of time and effort to make sure that, you know, everything we're doing over here is really, you know, the best of the best. And we're doing some really unique things as well with, you know, koa, with black limba, white limba. We're even doing some redwood tops.
Yeah.
We're doing a little bit of everything.
We're in the USA shop now, and these are all for the USA mm-hmm. guitars. But again, touching on this exotic wood stuff, mm-hmm. this trickles down to all the Japanese stuff and the LTD stuff as well.
Absolutely.
You're always very aware of like the exotics and what to use and to make exactly. it look aesthetically very pleasing.
Absolutely.
It does smell really good in here.
Here's a good one to show off, actually. So this is koa.
Yeah.
This would be one top for one guitar.
Koa is such a unique.
So good for
me. Yeah.
You know, you can only harvest koa after the tree has fallen over.
Yeah.
So if you notice, koa stock is always kind of in and out because depending on when there's storms in Hawaii, that's when you get to harvest koa mm-hmm. and you can get it. So it's a very special wood. It's very unique sounding.
Yeah. Lovely snack to it.
Such a snap, mm-hmm. nice airy. It's just like, it's one of my favorite tone woods, I think.
I can feel all the tone wood guys kicking off in the comments now.
Oh,
it does make a difference. When you play as many guitars as you do, it does make a difference.
You do get used to the subtle differences when you play enough.
For sure.
It's true.
For sure.
So, something like this will be a absolutely exquisite looking guitar when it's put on something.
Can I just pick this up and hold it? Because it looks lovely.
Is that yes. Oh. So yeah, you
That's
can see.
Beautiful.
That's just a bare TE body.
Yep. Recessed Floyd and everything. Top mounted pickups.
Yeah. That beautiful flame maple top.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah.
You see the new input jack on this, the one down here as well. So in our 2022 rundown, Tony shows me an awesome TE and it's got this new little route for the input jack. It's awesome.
You can see like a Horizon body right here. And you can also see we're looking for when we're putting these together. So we have extremely high standards of quality when it comes to the USA shop, especially when it comes to the tops. You know, something like this has been earmarked because it's a problem. This isn't gonna make it, so I'll tell you right now.
I mean, if it's a bit cheaper, I'll happily take this as an ESP USA custom shop. If he's gonna chuck it away,
Well, you know, meet me out back in like 5 minutes and we can work it out.
Hell yeah, let's
do it. But yeah, you know, something like this, again, we take a lot of pride in our standards and how high quality, you know, we want to
make. Well, you set such a high standard for yourself anyways. Like, you have to keep it. Now you've got that standard.
That's the game we're playing. So we're not trying to move backwards. We're trying to move forward and just make it even better than it was.
As always, for sure. Well, thanks for showing me this room, man. It's awesome.
Absolutely.
So we've just left final assembly. We're heading through the wood shop now.
Yep. Let's do it.
Where dreams are made.
Where dreams are literally made.
Look at these! This is cool. This is cool already.
So, this right here is Gil Vasquez. Mm-hmm. He is our ESP USA master builder.
Amazing.
And as you can see, he is hard at work right now, setting something up here in the CNC.
What's that, a single pickup M1 or something?
It looks like it. What's up, Gil?
M1, hey, good.
How you doing, man?
Hi. Nice to meet you, dude.
This is Gil.
Nice to meet you, I'm Dagan.
Gil's our master painter. I'm gonna go with one of these.
Yeah.
Don't leave me hanging. All right, so what Gil's doing here is, I think he's filing the nut or getting the nut ready to be cut.
For the Floyd, yeah.
Yes.
It's so cool because CNC has made everything so much more consistent.
Absolutely.
And perfect, and again, that whole ESP ethos, it has to be perfect. You can't half-ass anything.
It has to be perfect, and you know, as you look around the shop, you can see that we have the CNC machine, but it's for what you were saying earlier about consistency.
Yeah.
You know, it cuts out a very general body shape, mm-hmm. and as you can see around us, there's nothing but hand sanding stations behind us and around in this room. So once it gives us, you know, a general cutout of the guitar, it really is handed off to our other guys here who do every section of the guitar by hand. Mm-hmm. You know, whether it's, you know, doing the neck sculpting for the heel joint or some of the bevels or whatever it is, you know, they help clean it up and make sure that it's exactly what it should be.
I'm going to tell you, with a CNC machine, it doesn't make it perfect, but it's not exactly like it's coming down on a conveyor belt.
Exactly.
There's one person operating one CNC machine for the entire USA ESP stuff. So the handmade quality is still very much
100%.
There.
100%. So yeah, it's for sake of consistency and yeah, just making sure that we can build guitars on the same level of quality.
Can we check out some of these body blanks for the the neck through? Seeing a neck through in person is just fantastic.
So this one's got a quilt top on it.
Mm-hmm.
It's got Floyd. So you can see the wood grain right there.
Mm-hmm.
Check it out.
Even before it gets to this though, can you check out that body
bike? So this is more what comes out.
Look at that's crazy.
That's where it starts.
That's where it all starts. Very nice. What are you working on there, man?
Now, this is an M1. This is an M1, basically Floyd. It is, I believe it's going to jam, possibly. I'm not sure.
Very cool.
I think it's definitely one of Miguel's though. But
going to Canada.
Yeah.
There you go.
Very nice one. Again, I'll let you squeeze this back in.
You got him packed pretty tight over here, Gil.
Sorry, buddy?
But you got him packed pretty tight over here.
Yeah, some of those are good and some of those are...
not so good.
They're not going to make the cut.
Yeah, it's all good.
But you'll never see a second USA, that's for sure.
And that's, you know, exactly what we were talking about. Yeah, exactly what I was talking about earlier with our levels of quality. Gil's the one who really makes that call of something's not good enough.
Yeah.
And we got high standards at USA.
Yeah, you have a good eye, man.
We will not send, you'll never see a second out there in the market.
Yeah.
We don't make seconds.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Incredible, man.
If we don't like them, if something doesn't make the cut, we'll do something with them or just something, but yeah.
I mean, I'll look after one. I'll take one back to England. It'll be fine. I'll just sneak it back in the case.
Or something after you.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Great work, man. Hey, keep doing it.
Nice meeting y'all.
Awesome. So awesome we got back here.
Walk around.
Again, no stupid machine sanders. Everything is, like I said before, done by hand and contoured by hand.
As you can see.
And some of the contouring is pretty intense on ESP guitars.
Absolutely.
So to do it by hand and to make it perfect, it's a talented bunch you've got here.
Well, it's a pivotal point, you know. The neck shape has to be right, that set through heel joint, you know, things like that. That's what we take a lot of pride in, is getting those things consistently, making them amazing and how they should be.
For sure, definitely.
You see this?
I never thought I'd ever see a box of ESP necks.
And that is a neck through.
Excellent, yeah. So for the guys and gals that don't know what a neck through is, the neck goes through the body and you pretty much attach on the wings, don't you? Like mahogany or...
This is a perfect example of that. You can see this one actually has a zebra wood top on it. So
this is going to be a beauty.
This will be a beauty of a guitar. But yeah. Basically just see a bunch of necks ready to go over here.
Fingerboards down there as well.
Yep. See the neck before it has the fingerboard on it. So it's got that double reinforcement for the truss rod cover. And this one's going to be a gold splatter, actually.
So the same one.
So it'll be kind of like the ones we saw earlier. Yeah. It's a very popular finish at the moment. So
I love it.
So yeah.
What's your personal favorite ESP headstock?
My personal favorite ESP headstock?
Because there's been some iconic ones over the years.
It's got to be this guy.
Yeah. I'm inclined to agree with you, man. That's my favorite.
The M headstock is where it's at.
Yeah.
I personally, I like it when it's reversed.
Yeah.
But this is the shape, either way. 100%.
You can always tell an ESP by that headstock.
Exactly. You just tell by the silhouette of it. You know what it is.
For sure, man. For sure.
But here's another Eclipse one. This one actually has a lacewood top on it. So
I guess it's optional as well, having the ESP USA on the 12 fret, because a couple of the ones next door just have the straight up 12 fret.
Yeah. Well, this one is actually, I guess, a bit of an older one. We're doing it, I think, for the Eclipses still, but I think we've moved away from that for some of the other models.
What wood is that as well? That's a very unique piece of wood, isn't it? It's a beautiful grain.
Yeah, this might be something special. This looks like some kind of limba to me on the back. So this might be a special NAMM piece or something like that going on. That's a little different.
Stay tuned for June this year. Get subscribed, and you'll see this on the stand.
Yeah, you'll see the finished part of this.
So Tony, we're here next to some bits of trees, aren't we?
Bits of trees.
This is where it all. It's so interesting to think that this is where it all starts. This is going to be someone's pride and joy. They're going to love and cherish this. Music's going to get made on this.
Somebody will cherish and love the instrument that is made out of this piece of wood. That's the goal.
Insane to see. So this is all mahogany, is it?
It is all mahogany, and it's awesome to see it at this point, because not everybody, you know, when you walk in a music store and you see a guitar hanging on a wall, you don't realize, you know, all the effort and detail and work that's been put into, especially an instrument like an ESP USA, which is every single detail is, you know, just obsessed over and made sure that it's at the highest possible quality. And like you said, it all starts here.
Yeah, amazing, man. And let's go to where it's close to the end, the paint shop. Is that just back there?
It's closer to the end, yeah.
Let's do it, yeah. This is even further away.
Yeah, I know.
That's where it all starts.
That's really where it all starts.
That's relicking to the highest level. Right, anyways. How's it going,
guys,
man?
This is Ryan.
Dagan from PMT.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
These are our friends from the UK. Ryan Dominguez is our insanely talented master painter here at ESP USA.
So you're the guy in charge of all these unbelievable looking finishes.
Yeah, they just kind of, you know, set me loose back here. And
you're playing it off so cool. You're like, it's amazing some of the work you do, mate. It's fantastic.
Well, thank you. I appreciate it.
Absolutely.
It's just kind of one of those things, like, you know, you do it every day, so to you, it's not that big of a deal.
For sure.
You know? Whereas somebody who does something I don't do every day, it's like, holy shit, like, you know.
Yeah, no,
you,
I totally
you're
get
doing
it,
something
man.
Crazy, but, you know.
What got you into ESP and the love for guitar penny?
So I graduated from GCA in 2003,
right.
2004, somewhere in there, which was the school owned by ESP. Basically, you know, just kind of applied to ESP, got the job doing tech stuff for a little bit, and took off to Arizona for a little bit, learned to paint doing cabinets, and came back, you know, back to ESP in about 2008. Was doing tech repairs for a little bit, moved into the warranty. They decided to open up, you know, the USA shop, and they knew that I had, you know, some paint experience, and asked me if I wanted to be in the paint department. And
so cool, man. Would you mind showing us a couple of these nice examples? Would that be all right?
Yeah,
or what
you're
working on now? Yeah. Or?
So right now, I'm just putting the logo on the back of this.
Oh, Jesus Christ, look at that.
Look at that beautiful thing. Oh my God, look at the top on that. Wow.
Line burst, teardrop kind of deal.
Ooh, and the satin?
Yeah, no, this one's just, it's gonna be gloss.
Oh, it's gonna be gloss?
Yeah.
I think it should be satin, but that's just me.
Yeah.
It looks amazing.
Wow.
Just doing logos on this one.
So
yeah,
true.
Right?
Yeah. So true. So yeah, as you can see, Ryan actually hand applies all the logos on the USA. So that's all done by hand by
that's
Ryan.
That's too high a stress level for me, man.
Again, when you're like diffusing bombs for a living.
Yeah.
Just another day for Ryan.
I get it. No, I get it. Yeah, for sure. So let's check out the paint booth itself now, where there's some amazing little samples on the wall and some guitars getting painted. So let's have a little nosy in.
If we had every sample of every color that we did, it would be, you know, it'd fill up probably that whole wall over there. But, you know, this is mostly for the ones that are just kind of a little bit trickier. You know, basically just try to keep them a little bit more consistent. You know, the mixture of the colors that goes on them. Maybe, you know, the lemon's a little bit darker than what we would use on like a vintage natural or something. So just to make sure that we keep everything nice and consistent for different colors and just have the samples up there, so.
That's some beautiful stuff, dude. Love the fade, love that one. That's so cool.
Yeah, I'm a huge fan of the red, well, rose essential thing that was next door. It looks killer, mate. It's such a beautiful guitar. Oh,
the one that's up front there? Yeah.
I showed him the new, are we calling it Red Marble? Or is it Red Rose?
I forget. We did it once before, and there was somebody that came and demoed it on the ESP site. It was on a M2.
Cameron did, yeah. I remember.
And I forget what we called the color. I think we just called it Red Swirl or something like that. But
it's beautiful, though.
Yeah. It should be a fun color to start doing, you know?
I love my guitar that you did.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. We did it on yours, too, yeah.
So is it like a trade secret, or how do you get that cool, like the color there, it's the green and the red. How would you go about getting a finish like that?
For this one there?
For that one down there, yeah.
So this one is basically, like a lot of the things that we do here, they're a stain underneath. So if you take a look at this Horizon that's out here, it's got the green stain on it. Right. That's gonna be a Lynch burst, so.
Oh, cool. We checked out one of them next door as well. Yeah. It looks so cool. Yeah.
So basically what we do, we just start with a stain. You know, we'll put the stain on there, we'll sand it back and get the kind of desired effect. So a lot of this is like end grain that kind of comes in and out, and it just sticks in the end grain when you sand it back. So once you sand it back, we seal it. Once the sealer's been leveled to, you know, once it's been leveled, we basically just take the color and just kind of spray over the top of it, whatever color we're gonna do. Whatever saturation of the color is going to be, you know, so.
What's your personal favorite finish to shoot a guitar in?
I hate them all.
Black or nothing, just straight up.
No, blacks, black and whites, they're the worst ones.
I was going to say, I know you love Snow White Satin. I know that's your favorite.
Oh, man.
Every little speck, you wouldn't think, but even on the blacks, every little speck that flies in, it just kind of pops out. So it's like 10 times worse on the white ones. It's personal favorite. I don't know. It really depends on, you know, every time we introduce a new color, it's my new personal favorite for, you know, maybe a month or two, and then I'm sick of seeing it and I don't ever want to do it again, you know. So it's
And it just means you're always excited for the next project coming up, which is, which is great.
He's always working on something new back here, so,
Try not to get in the rut of getting, you know, being too bored with what we're doing. And
well, ESP constantly push the kind of envelope of how guitars can look. They're always exciting new finishes and colors and grains and fades. Like, we had next door, there's an amazing fade on that Horizon. Can we check that out? Is that okay?
Yeah, for sure.
I'll let you lead the way, dude. It's your shop.
So this one here, this is the Purple Haze. We call this one Purple Haze. We have a Purple Haze fade, and then we have a Purple Haze burst. The Purple Haze burst is actually out there. It's a little bit different than this one. It doesn't necessarily incorporate all the blues that are in there, but.
How long does it take to cure usually?
So this one is mostly done by hand. So this is a hand stain only finish.
Okay, cool.
You know, waiting for the stain to dry, and then going back over it with the other stains over the top usually takes, you know, working time maybe 20-30 minutes, you know, but about an hour and a half altogether, waiting for, you know, dry times and that sort of thing.
The matching headstock's beautiful as well.
Yeah.
The fact that it goes in the opposite fade as well.
It's
a nice little touch.
So it's kind of, you know, the standard thing, I guess, would be to just kind of start the fade over from the bottom and then go up towards the top. So it's kind of nice to have something that's a little bit different and
nice
just kind of meet it in the middle.
Yeah, you look at it, it's visually, it makes sense.
So you can kind of look at it as like a giant burst, you know, that kind of goes around that way, but yeah.
Thank you so much for taking time out to talk to us today, man. This is great. Just want to touch a little bit more on Ryan. He was saying 20-30 minutes to do that amazing paint as if it's nothing. But it only takes him 20-30 minutes because he's amazing at his job, isn't it? For us mere mortals, it would take so much bloody longer.
For us mere mortals, it's hard to comprehend the level of mastery that Ryan has.
Yeah, he's so laid back as well. I was like, just paint it. But you said he can blast a guitar in no time and it'll be perfect.
I've seen him do it. It is quite astounding. He's a true master. So
hell yeah. What we're doing, he's called Sponge Brick.
Sponge Brick on the Instagram. If you want to look him up on Instagram, Sponge Brick. He's got some good stuff on there. But Yeah, he's a big reason why what we're doing here at ESP USA is so special, because, you know, Ryan's part of it, you know, really pushing forward these new finishes. We're making guitars that don't look like anything else.
No, so I wholeheartedly agree. It's so special in there. Thank you so much for taking me on a tour.
No problem.
And the close-knit nature of the group I've met here at ESP is just something that you rarely see. So it's been an absolute pleasure, Tony, Miguel, and the California Sun outside of ESP USA. For all this ESP links, click the description box down below for all the PMT goodies. Thank you both so much for your time.
Of course, man.
Cheers, dude.
Cheers.
Miguel, you're a star.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, dude. Cheers. Have a good one, guys.